Della Ashby says she arrived at the OKEU hospital with her father on Friday, August 14th, around 7:30 p.m. Her father, who is a diabetic, was admitted at the facility, but when she and her siblings arrived the following day, the hospital did not appear to have any record of him having been admitted. Finally, after checking through the files, Ashby was told that her father had been transferred to the Victoria Hospital for a COVID-19 test after he had displayed flu-like symptoms. He tested negative and was returned to the OKEU Hospital. When Ashby saw her father upon his return, she noticed that he was wearing the same clothing that he wore on Friday when they brought him to the hospital.
We went back to the hospital Saturday morning and they couldn't find my father. The nurse didn't know who he was or where he was until they found information and they told us that he was transferred to Victoria Hospital because he was coughing, and so they sent him there to be tested for corona. My father's coughing is a direct result to the situation with his feet. When you have elevated sugar levels, you get that situation happening. I think the hospital should have known that, but I guess since we're in the state of emergency and all of this, they sent my father to VH. But they didn't call us and they didn't tell us. They didn't tell anybody anything. We got to Victoria, and since he was at emergency, we were allowed to see him. And we spoke to him. He told us that they didn't even tell him that he was going to Victoria. When he was put in the ambulance, he asked them, what are they doing with him? Where are they taking him?
According to Della Ashby, her father was asked to go to the bathroom to take a shower, but with tissues under his feet removed and two toes lost because of his medical condition, he has been bedridden for the past couple of months and is unable to care for himself.
To ask him to get off the bed, he's bedridden. He's been bedridden for about 2 months now. To ask him to get off the bed and to go to the bathroom and get cleaned. So we attended to him. We lodged a complaint with the hospital. We have been asked to follow up. I have tried. I tried yesterday, but I couldn't get to speak to anybody. I'm going back again today to try to speak to somebody to see if we can get some kind of answers. And not really answers, because I'm not expecting to get answers, but at least for the hospital to reevaluate their system, because we understand that that is happening to other people. So we need the hospital to reevaluate their systems. Because you cannot do that to people's families, especially if those family members are accustomed to being taken care of by their families. You need to understand the emotional trauma that it causes, the psychological trauma that it causes family members.
The Ministry of Health has promised to issue a statement on the matter. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.